Hey guys, it's Giridhar here, and today in this video, let's have a detailed review of the Vivo V7 Plus. Following the success of Vivo V5, V5 Plus and the V5S, Vivo has now introduced the V7 Plus in India. The V7 Plus has a metallic finish and it is of a good quality plastic. The mobile is long and thin in profile. It is easy to hold. It has a dedicated SD card slot. It may not have a great premium feel in the hand, but it definitely has a good quality build. The chrome highlights above and below the mobile and also the body colored fingerprint sensors gives it a good aesthetic appeal. Overall, the V7 Plus has a good feel in the hand and the display is the key highlight of the V7 Plus. It is a 5.99, almost 6-inch diagonally long display. Vivo has gone in for a bezel-less display, but then this is a 720p display. The display is bright and has good colors. Yet the 720p resolution on a big screen makes you notice the quality after using it, especially while comparing a full HD resolution side by side. The pixels per inch is just 269. The pixel density, the resolution is all low, but a regular user, a normal mobile phone user, would not notice it unless he's pixel peeping. It is good to see an innovation in Vivo mobile after a long time. Vivo usually is all about selfie mobiles, and now, apart from this one being a selfie-centric mobile, it also brings a edge-to-edge display, which is an infinity screen on this price range. The V7 Plus is priced at ₹22,000. At this price range, Snapdragon 625 would have been a great choice, but Vivo has opted for a newer processor called the Snapdragon 450. Thankfully, it is a Snapdragon processor, unlike the earlier mobiles from Vivo which were powered with MediaTek processor. This one is running on a Snapdragon processor. The Snapdragon 450 is highly identical to Snapdragon 625. It is a major improvement from Snapdragon 435. Other than that, the mobile has got 4GB of RAM and 64GB of storage. The UI is responsive. I've installed almost 40 apps in it. All the apps run smoothly and without any glitches. The mobile also has good memory management. I also played some graphically intensive games on this mobile. Though the graphic quality is not that great owing to the 720p display, I find no heating issue and the mobile has a smoother gameplay. The audio quality over the speakers is loud and clear. I tried with many different headsets and I also found the audio to be of good quality over them. When it comes to Vivo mobile, the primary mobile is the selfie mobile. So let's talk about the front-facing camera first. Just after the Vivo V7 Plus was launched, there were a lot of controversies around it, especially regarding the megapixel count of the front-facing camera. It is still not clear whether the front-facing camera is a 24 megapixel or a 19 megapixel sensor. But as I usually say on all my reviews, megapixel is only one factor which determines the quality of the picture. So let's look at how the quality of the picture is. Under daylight, the selfie camera can click some really sharp selfies. It has good details, natural colors, and nice skin tone. Under low light, the images are good but not sharp. It has noise and the moonlight selfie flash is weak. The rear camera, which is a 16 megapixel sensor, has got good details and sharpness. It is fast to focus, the colors are natural, and has the right exposure. Even under low light conditions, it has got decent performance, but you need to have a steady hand to click a sharp image. The mobile can shoot 1080p videos both on the front and the rear camera. There is no optical image stabilization or even electronic image stabilization, but the footage out of the mobile has got good color reproduction, though it is shaky a bit. The camera performance of the Vivo V7 Plus will not disappoint you, but at the same time, it won't excite you either. Vivo V7 Plus is running on Android 7.1.2 with FunTouch OS 3.2 on top of it. FunTouch OS has got a bunch of features. Some of my favorite features here are the app clone, the one-handed operation, the smart split-screen application, and a lot of gestures to control the mobile, virtual navigation keys, which actually gets rid of your on-screen navigation key and controls the entire mobile using gestures. I have been using the mobile for over 2 weeks now and I notice no lags. The UI is fast and smooth. Vivo V7 Plus has got a 3225 mAh of battery. The mobile can get charged from 0 to 100% in about 2 hours. By the way, the mobile comes with a 5 volt 2 ampere charger, which is a fast charger but not a quick charger. So once charged, the mobile lasts for little more than a single working day. On moderate usage, I still find about 20 to 25% of charge left at the end of a day. The usual complaint against Vivo mobiles are they have low-end specifications, especially weak processors. And the common allegation is that Vivo concentrates only on selfie, no innovation. But now, with the Vivo V7 Plus, Vivo has stepped in to make changes. The bezel-less display on a mid-range mobile is a huge welcome. It has got a new design, a new display, and a newest processor. Snapdragon 450 is close to 625, and it is a huge upgrade from 435. But Vivo must come out of the selfie game. It is over. It is stale. People want a mobile that can also click a good selfie. However, we don't want a great selfie camera that can also be a mobile. Having said that, I spoke to many Vivo customers who have bought Vivo mobiles and using it on their day-to-day life. They're all happy. They are happy because the mobile has got a good market presence, the sales and service network is great, and Vivo V7 Plus is for the offline market and hence the high price. No point comparing it with the other mobiles which are available online. If you walk into a store, high chances are that the sales guy will push you a V7 Plus, but low chances that you will be disappointed with it. If you're not gonna walk into a store, if you can buy a mobile online, hold on, you may not have to buy the Vivo V7 Plus. So many interesting mobiles coming your way. I hope you like this video. If you like to watch more of my videos, make sure to subscribe to my channel Phonelicious. Until I catch up with you on the next video, this is Giridhar signing off. Goodbye. Signing off.